Hello, namaste, namaskaram, vanakkam. I hope everyone is doing good. Be strong and take care of your health. Today we'll discuss about second continued session of consignment process and its configuration in Fusion Cloud. If you have not watched earlier session, I suggest you to watch and continue with this session. Okay. Before that, just to give overview of my profile, my name is Amarinder Sudini, having 15 years of experience in Oracle apps, including on-premise, Oracle, and in cloud applications. If you have any queries, you can reach me on 7013909210. If you are looking to build your career in Oracle Cloud or any further training, I suggest you to please contact Nana, who can guide you, and he is the best trainer who can train you in short period of time. Okay, you can go and search oraclenana.com in Google and you can reach him. Okay, today we'll be discussing about the configurations. Let me share the screen. Okay. These are the few checklist which are mandatory and few are optional setups which might be used for configuration of the consignment inventory process. Okay, so first thing is items. Okay, the decision of creating a separate item codes for consignment is required or not. Okay, to answer that. Separate item codes are not required to create the consignment purchase orders. Okay, even the normal item codes which are already part of your item master and which are purchased, those are enough to place them in the consignment agreement and in the consignment order. Okay, separate item code is only suggestible if you are going to plan. If you are going to plan the min-max on your item code so that your requisitions and purchase orders gets created automatically. That is the only case. Okay, let me go to the items and show you. The reason why we do not want to suggest a separate item code is that because your item master will be increasing unnecessarily, okay, for which you do not have to, but for the process will still continue with your regular item codes. Okay, you have to go to the product management and you have to go to the product information management. The reason why I'm going to this particular section is I'm not going to create separate item code for that one, but the existing item code itself, I will be using that one. Okay, there is no extra benefit that we are getting for the creation of the new item. Okay, go to the item and click on search. I have created an item with a demo unsigned item. This is a normal item. Okay, but the name I provided as a demo consigned item. If you go to this item code, you will see this is a normal inventory kind of item itself. There is no specific attributes have been enabled. I have not enabled any planning for this item, nor it is a consignment item. Okay. If you go to the you can see this is the overview section. If you're looking more details on item creation, you can watch earlier videos of Nana. He might have explained the details of item creation process. If you're looking any further details on this specific area, also you can post your comments. We will get back to you on this one. Okay, go to the specifications. Under specifications, you can see that the item is an inventory item where costing is enabled and your inventory asset value is yes. Okay, this is important. Okay, this is one of the checkpoint you need to check for the items. Okay, then go to the planning. The planning, if you see, this item is not a consigned enabled item. Okay, but still, I will show you how this item can be placed in the consignment process. Okay, there is no, it is not mandatory that you need to enable this particular field over here. Might be we need to see where exactly this will be useful. For example, to generate your TAD charge accounts based on these attributes while raising the purchase requisitions, that might be helpful or for any reporting purpose. But functionality wise, this has no impact. And you can leave as it is, okay. And the purchasing side, it's a purchase and purchasable. That's it. These options we can leave it as a blank, and you can even enable it at your purchase order level, okay. Just close it. This is related to the item. If you go to the supplier, supplier also, there is, you can use any supplier who has iSupplier portal access, or if you wanted to do a normal transaction without iSupplier portal access, that is also suffice. So no specific configuration is required at the supplier level. Okay, I will show you even for that. Go to the procurement, go to suppliers. Here we have consigned. This is a normal supplier, but the naming convention which I have used here for the demonstration purpose to understand clearly that this is a consignment process. The naming convention itself I have used as a consignment, but the creation process is same. There is no difference for this supplier when compared to the normal creation of the suppliers. Okay. The profile change request is pending for this supplier. Since it is a demo instance, right? Someone might have used this vendor and they initiated the profile change request. Click on this vendor. I'm just canceling this change request, okay? So unnecessarily again, you can see here under general section, its name is consignment supplier. The regular fields are normal. It is spend authorized vendor, tax organization type is corporation, and okay, it is a what are the other details? Everything is normal. Okay, there is no specific details I have captured for the supplier. Go to the sites. The instance is a little bit slow, seems like that. When you go to the sites, click on this edit button. Do not make any changes. The reason why I wanted to show here is there are some options related to consignment, and it is not required or mandatory. So when you should actually go to this specific configuration, I will tell you on this one. Let that screen open. The system is slow. Click on this edit button. We have seen for items, we have seen for suppliers, then we'll go for the document styles also. Once this has been completed, Arush is my son. Okay, that is the Wi-Fi that I connected over here. So under site assignments, okay, when you click on edit, go to the purchasing section. Here you can see one section related to consigned inventory. Okay, this is not mandatory. Okay, if you are sure when you should actually go to this particular configuration is if you are sure that the material which you are going to purchase from the vendor and it is very frequent that this vendor will supply a consignment material apart from your normal purchases, and you can specify your details over here. Aging onset point, aging period days, consumption advice frequency, consumption advice summary, and pay on use. Okay, I will tell you the importance of these fields. Okay, aging onset point. Aging onset point, basically this will determine when you should start your aging period for the consignment. Suppose say a vendor has shipped the material, in that case, after receiving the material, you wanted to calculate the days. Means suppose once you receive the material at your warehouse location, after 60 days before 60 days the ownership will be with the vendor itself. Okay, but after 60 days the ownership will not be the vendor, and the buying organization will become the ownership. So that aging period, how do you want to calculate? Based on your terms, right? Whether it is based on the shipment, like when ASN is created from the supplier portal, or when supplier ship the material, you wanted to calculate from that point of time, or when you actually receive the material in your warehouse, from that point of time, you wanted to calculate, okay? After 60 days, or it can be 60, 90, whatever the agreement that is agreed with your vendor and your buying organization, those days with the vendor, you can specify over here, okay? The same thing will get defaulted in your consignment purchase order. This is only to get defaulted in your consignment order, and it has nothing that this is a mandatory step or to configure it over here, okay? And consumption advice frequency, we have three options. One is daily, weekly, and monthly. Basically, as soon as you consume the material, suppose 100 quantity is there, you received it, but after 20 days, you consumed 20 quantity. So that 20 quantity, supplier should able to create the invoice. So this consumption advice, there is a program which will decide how much has been consumed. And once this program has been generated, right, based on these parameters, system will generate a program and inform the vendor that, yes, these are the quantities which have been consumed by the vendor, and you can raise invoice for that one. Without consumption, within below 60 days, vendor cannot create an invoice. Okay, that is the process of consumption. Okay, now how do you wanted to generate consumption advice summary? Whether this summary you wanted to, this is a report basically. You wanted to generate consolidating of all the organizations, or you wanted to give organization item combination, or you wanted to go with only single organization, organization item and transaction. It is based upon how you wanted to see that reporting structure. Okay. Pay on use. Okay. Pay on use is a functionality where as soon as your payment, as soon as your consumption has been run, right, you are using that material, then automatically there is a program which can create invoice and payment can be done to the vendor. Okay, this is the functionality of that one. Okay, this is about the configuration related to vendor side, but it is not required. I will not do anything. Okay, I will keep it as a blank. Okay, I will keep it as a blank. I will not update anything. Leave rest of the configuration as it is for the suppliers. You just create it as a normal vendor itself. Okay? Now you can see I rejected the profile change request. Now it is a normal. I can use this vendor in my transactions. Let me go to the setup and maintenance. The next configuration step is document styles. Okay, this is also an optional configuration. The reason why I'm going telling over here is you need to understand what is the purpose of this one in the cloud application. Okay, consignment agreement is not a specific what document style, okay, document category or like BPA, CPA. It is basically your child style. Click on go to this procurement, click on manage document styles. You can go to the global search and search for manage document styles. Okay, when you go over here, okay, it is a child of blanket purchase agreement. Okay, you can say it is a child of blanket purchase agreement. You can create your own style so that this style will be appearing while you are creating your agreement. Okay, this is a standard one which Oracle provides. Click on edit. Okay, now this style you cannot change it. Okay, if you wanted to use your custom style like from your client specific naming convention like ABC consignment agreement, ABC consignment order, something like that, you wanted to use it, okay, then you have to create a custom style. Basically this is your blanket purchase agreement itself. Okay, blanket purchase agreement, if you are able to see, right, this is basically your blanket purchase agreement, but child of blanket purchase agreement, you can say, not exactly. You cannot create a BPA and you can tell that this is a consignment agreement. You have to use this specific style, then only this is considered as a consignment agreement. Okay, close this one. You can rename. Okay, now we hear ABC. If you wanted to see consignment order, the same consignment agreement, if you wanted to see ABC, the same naming convention will be reflecting over there. Otherwise, standard consignment order, consignment agreement, based on your requirement, you can enable that one. The next step is, let's go to the configure procurement business unit. The reason why I showed this specific style is because there might be cases where business want to use their own naming convention for consignment instead of the normal naming convention, right? Oracle provided, they wanted to create add prefix or suffix or something like that based on the requirement. In this case, you have to go to this specific task and change the naming convention. So the same name will appear during creation of your documents. Go to the configure procurement business function, which you can see under procurement area, under procurement foundation, go to configure procurement business function. Okay. This is also not a mandatory configuration. This is also to default. Okay. If you are going to default the data over here, this will be coming. Otherwise, it will first check, it will check over here. It is not there. It will check at the supplier side. It is not there. Then user need to provide data manually in the agreement or the purchase order, consignment order. The information is only used to default your specific document or transaction that you are going to create it. You see here, consignment terms are there. The same terms which we specified, right, at the supplier level. This will be coming, okay, for any of the supplier that you create, right? This will be defaulting. Receipt aging set point is receipt, aging period is 1 day, consumption advice frequency is daily, and all. If you wanted to change, you can change it. Otherwise, you can override at your specific document level, okay? Now, you have to choose, means before doing any transaction, right, your basic procurement related configuration need to be in place, for which it requires your inventory organization. At least your one inventory organization should be existing. For that one, go to manufacturing and supply chain area. There is no specific configuration related to inventory organization, but to ensure that we need to have one inventory organization. So here just we wanted to tell you what organization that we'll be using for the placing the consignment order or consignment agreement. Okay, seems there is some issue with the navigation to this particular okay task. In that case, what you have to do is there are two options. If you are having any issue, right, go to this global task. You are getting issue there. You search over here because some issues are happening, some tasks which are not opening over there from there. You can open it from here. Even if you have an issue in opening from here, that is a problem with the instance. There is a problem with the instance in navigating this specific inventory organization. Okay, leave about that one. For this one, if you see, this organization is already in place. I wanted to show you that there is no specific configuration for that one. You can use any of your existing inventory organization and any subinventory. There is also no restriction that you have to use expense subinventory or receiving subinventory or storage subinventory, anything like that. You need to have at least these two subinventories, so receiving subinventory and storage subinventory. Receiving subinventory, basically we will be using it if you wanted to do any inspection kind of things based on our routing mechanism. Storage subinventory, if it is used for direct delivery, okay, directly you receive the material. There is no specific subinventory can be used for expense subinventory. It is not required. There is no need. Can receive the material in your normal asset subinventory itself. Okay, we have those subinventory asset subinventory that is already been there. Let me go to the procurement agent. Let me go to the subinventories. Okay, for the specific inventory organization. The system is slow. I'm not sure. Might be huge number users are using that one. So here I have not defined any subinventory, but it is suggested. Okay, for any concerned material, right? You define a new subinventory for consignment. Let me define it. Okay, we will receive the material in that subinventory itself, which will be useful for us for immediate. What navigation or checking the material. Okay. If you wanted to enable the locator control, you can enable. In this case, I do not need that one. I'm keeping as an asset subinventory. If you uncheck this, it becomes an expense subinventory. Okay, this is a storage subinventory. Okay, I'm just clicking on save. So whatever the material that we receive, right, for consignment, we will receive in this subinventory, so that it will be easy for us when we query your on hand quantities, right? It will be easy. So it is not a mandatory thing. It is only for our just identification purpose. But there might be cases where you can transfer the material from this consigned subinventory to other subinventories, even though the material in the other subinventories will still remain as a consigned material. So it doesn't mean that consigned material should always be in the same consigned subinventory, even though you can transfer. Subinventory transfers without ownership change, the material will still can be transferred to other subinventories and ownership will be with the vendor itself. Okay, I have one receiving subinventory, staging subinventory here, and I have one consigned subinventory. I have another subinventory. Okay, so this is fine. Next, we'll go to the procurement agent. Procurement agent. This is part of your purchasing configuration. No specific configuration, additional configuration is required for consignment. The only thing is for your testing purpose, what are the things that you wanted to enable it? One, the requisition business unit, procurement business unit, which you wanted to place the orders, right? That it should be given access. In this case, my procurement and requisition business unit are same, and I have access to create the requisitions, I have access to create orders and purchase agreements. These three are important, okay? Apart from that, if you wanted to create the suppliers, right, for consignment, this is important. Ensure these are enabled and provided full access, okay? Coming with the roles, right? These are the roles that we have to provide to the users, apart from providing the data access, okay? For more details, how to add, provide data access, there are separate videos available. You can watch that one. I will show you one example. Go to the security console. Query the user for which you are going to do the transaction. The specific roles, okay, these are already added. If you are creating a new user, right, ensure that these roles are added, okay. I will tell you the need for these specific roles. Warehouse manager is used to receive the stock and to perform the inventory related transactions. Transfer to owned transactions, all these related inventory transactions, this warehouse manager role is required. Advanced procurement requester is used to creating the requisitions. So why do we need to create the requisitions? I said in the earlier session, that is one of the best practice where you can create a consignment order, okay, to initiate the process. Product data steward, this is used for your testing purpose. Basically, this will not, you will not give to the end users, okay. There will be a separate team, but for your testing purpose, to create any item, all right, for a testing purpose, so you can use this role. Cost accounting and receipt accounting, these are required for your review of your accounting and transfer the cost that has been generated, right, to your respective modules from your receiving and costing to the ledgers. Okay, these are the roles required. Yeah, I'll show you how to add it. Okay, click on add role, because this role is added, already added. You just copy that role and click on add role and paste it over here. Because I already added, it will not come. Cost accountant copy is coming, but cost accountant role is already there. That is the reason it is not coming. Okay. Similar way, you just copy it and add it. You can see cost accountant is already added. Okay. In this way, all the mentioned roles, you just add it and save it. Okay. After saving, go to the setup and maintenance and provide data access to this specific roles to your user ID. What are the user ID that you are going to create these transactions, right? For those users, give this data access. I'm just going to equipment function. Manage business unit D. Or you can directly go to the global search and search it over there. The role has already been added. You just directly go, click on paste button. And enter your user ID. Okay, the role I already added, so system will not accept now. You select the roles, okay. Suppose a cost accountant is there, for which you wanted to do for whole business unit and cost organization, right? US operations. Okay, this is my first organization. And you can give the same cost accountant to the business unit also. So this role is already added. This data access is already added. System is not taking that one. Okay. In this way, you just keep on adding all the respective data access to the user. Okay. This is how about defining the some few of the configurations. Then the important configuration is costing. Okay. This from this part, I will tell you in the another session. Okay. This is an important critical step. It is required for consignment. I will explain you in the next session. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any queries till now on this process or the configuration, you can feel free to reach. Thank you. Thank you very much.